I'm in.
How are you? I'm Chris Holland from Century.
Alex Greenhead, Marketing Department at Sports.
So the reason I'm meeting with you today, I represent a Century consulting firm, and we've been looking over your financials and talked to a couple of people in your company, and they seem to have an interest of doing business with us to improve your next couple fiscal years.
Well, it's safe to say, if you've seen your stocks,
it's not looking so good. So after reading online, I mean, just basic customer reviews and doing some market research, we found out a lot of people think the store needs a facelift. It's just dated. A lot of people can go to the other stores because yours are dated at this point.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're pretty ordinary, mm-hmm. I guess, if you have seen any other stores. Nothing mm-hmm. has much
traditional.
Changed. Yeah, it's hasn't really much changed in the past 10, 15 years.
Exactly. So, I mean, who are you seeing as your main competitors of why you're doing as bad as you are right now?
Probably Dick's Sporting Goods, especially. They kill us. They have a higher online purchasing approach than mm-hmm. we do, which is the trending thing mm-hmm. in this day and age. And that's one thing, I guess, some of our marketing department just fails to grasp because they're so dead set on traditional mm-hmm. ways, so just going in the store and buying it.
Yeah.
So, with that being said, we also kind of need, like I said, a facelift, I guess, like a mm-hmm. refurnishing or a
rebranding without a rebrand.
Basically. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, I mean, after looking at that, I mean, if you're wanting to get in the social media network world, you need to get in some click advertising ASAP. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you've done any research on that or know about that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we've done quite a bit.
Yeah. And then, I mean, if you go on there, like I said, there are a lot of your customers, they like the store, there's just, it's old, it's dated, there's not as many of them around anymore, that's a big problem too,
exactly.
And when they are, they're in very low income areas, it seems.
Yeah.
Now.
Another problem, I guess, we, you know, there's not a lot of them, we also don't have a lot of employees that are willing to go work there,
mm-hmm.
so when you go into a typical store, it's not, you know, 10 to 15 retail salesmen out there trying to sell our products, it's like 3
mm-hmm.
and 5.
Yeah.
And that's a big problem.
Yeah, exactly.
So we don't exactly push our customers to buy our products
mm-hmm.
like Dick's Sporting Goods do and other sports stores such as
mm-hmm.
Nike.
Exactly. So I mean, from what I've seen, like you do a lot of like paper ads and things of that nature, which reaches a certain generation, but it's not going to reach millennials and the people who are actually on
yes.
social media all the time. That's a big problem. So.
That's our large purse.
Right? Yeah. So that we could definitely bring in a team. That's not even a problem. Bring in a social marketing specific team just to get you through the basics. Go through all your, especially see what people are saying about you. That's the biggest thing. See what your customers want.
Okay. Who exactly have you consulted in the past to help with this issue?
We've consulted with a couple companies to consult with this. One of which we've actually consulted with people who do cloud-based communications, Telitalia, Ducati especially. They needed more social media presence.
Okay. Yeah, I've heard of cloud-based. They're actually phenomenal. I heard that y'all do American Express as well.
Yeah, they're actually $7 billion in customers added since we helped them.
Wow. Yeah, that was a lot, man.
Yeah. So, I mean, it was very successful. That's over quite a few fiscal years, but still, it's a very large improvement from where they were before. So we can bring in a team next time, and I can schedule that meeting later on this week. Do you want to do that?
Yeah, for sure. I will get a hold of the department.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thanks for coming in.